Sundays, and we play some of the best new music of the week. And at that time, you can vote for your favorite.
20th Century 98 Rock, the 98 Rockumentary, a 23-year retrospective. 1978.
The first test tube baby is born to a British couple. More than 900 American followers of cult leader Jim Jones commit mass suicide at their South American compound. Hustler magazine owner Larry Flynt is shot and critically wounded by a would-be assassin.
78.
Leon Spinks takes the World Heavyweight Boxing Championship from Muhammad Ali in Las Vegas. TV's top 20 includes WKRP in Cincinnati, Mork and Mindy, Taxi, Alice, What's Happening, and Soap. The top three movies of the year are National Lampoon's Ass, Superman, and Grease. The Saturday Night Fever soundtrack dominates the charts.
1978.
Morning man Mark Woodworth, who was with 98 Rock from 77 through late in 1988.
My strongest, most amazing memory of being at 98 Rock, outside of working with Lopez, was Disco Destruction, when we blew up Disco Records on the morning show with sound effects. That year at the State Fair, thousands of people started chanting, "Disco sucks. Disco sucks."
Sarah Fleischer recalls a funny moment in her career.
I had a big, big blooper. We had this promotion going on. For $10, you could get a haircut and a blow dry. I go on the air, it's Saturday afternoon, and I said, for $10, you can get a haircut and a blow dry. And I thought I was going to die. A haircut and a blow dry. After I said it, I saw my career flash before my eyes.
Also in 78, The Who's drummer Keith Moon dies of a drug overdose at age 32. The Sex Pistols arrive in America for their first tour, and John Belushi and Dan Aykroyd debut their alter egos, the Blues Brothers.
And 98 Rock released the 98 Rock first album in 1978.
Some of the year's big rock albums in 1978 include Jackson Brown, Running on Empty, much of which was recorded live at Merriweather Post Pavilion on October 27, 1977. Also, Some Girls from the Rolling Stones, Bob Seger's Stranger in Town, and the debut albums from Van Halen and The Cars, and Boston's Don't Look Back.
1978.
In 1978, Ted Nugent was in the studio, and he just gave me a big one.
20th Century 98 Rock, the 98 Rockumentary, a 20. 20-